All-Star Tournament, we have the results from the first qualification round. We now know the first six teams that will be competing for that $250,000 grand prize, tickets to All-Star Saturday night, and tickets to the All-Star game. The competition was fierce, and today we have Dazar to break it all down.
It's your man Dazar here with the All-Star Tournament update. The leaderboard was in constant fluctuation during the five-hour competition, with the elite teams trading position with every win. A part of last year's championship team, Mr. Styles, in the new look Drukabacher's HG, took an early exit to Always Open. While the other four members of the champion Drukabacher's formed Yeah That Way and ended up with five wins. Last year's runner-up, GFG, came close to qualifying in the first round, reaching the top qualifying spot multiple times this game day, but ended up with a heartbreaking fourth-place finish as other teams finished games right at the end of the time limit. So who are the first six teams to get into the All-Star Tournament bracket? Two Live Crew, One Way, Island Gang, Trust the Process 2, Hoop Supremacy, and For Your Eyes Only. But now it's your time to get into the tournament. The next qualification round is Saturday from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. Pacific time. Get as many wins as you can to increase your team's score on the leaderboard. And join these teams in the chase for the grand prize. Good luck to all the gamers out there. If anything is clear, these Elite 2K Pro-Am teams are not messing around. So get your team together, get those wins, and qualify for the All-Star Tournament.
My NBA 2K17 cover athlete Karl Anthony Towns and D'Angelo Russell go way back. So when it came time for their mocap session, they hopped on the court together. And we caught up with D'Angelo afterwards. What's up, guys? Today I'm here with D'Angelo Russell at mocap.
Yep.
You got to suit up today. Was that your first time?
Definitely, yeah. You get to see what it really does. I mean, the gestures and your jump shot, everything goes is involved with the 2K and the games.
And you've known Karl for a little while now.
Mm-hmm.
When did you guys first meet?
I would say in high school. We played against each other and it was a heated atmosphere. They had us down the whole game, and we finally came back and pulled it off. It was a fun game.
And now fast forward to a few years later, what has been your favorite part about LA so far?
It's a lot of stuff to do off the court. I'm a paintball guy, and there's many different locations you can go to, so you're not really missing too much anywhere else.
And this season, do you feel any added pressure now that Kobe is not on the court?
Definitely. The last game was probably the craziest game I've ever been a part of. And I just seen how the fans reacted. They wanted him to shoot every shot. So when anybody else got the ball, they were just booing him. And even we're on his team and they were booing us. So we looked like chickens with our heads cut off trying to get that man the ball. But he's left a heck of a legacy behind. And we're just trying to fulfill it and just bring it back.
And I heard that you do play 2K.
Yeah.
A little bit.
Mm-hmm.
What is your favorite mode?
I like to play against players, against my brothers, whoever wants to play.
Quick games.
Yeah, that's my thing. I don't really play like online or do any of that.
Do you play in the same style in 2K as you do on the court?
Kinda. They did a great job of the mocap, you know, so they do a great job of trying to get everybody down packed, like what they do, how they shoot, how they finish, whatever it is. That's the best part of the game. It's so realistic. A lot of guys that are fans that aren't in the league getting an opportunity to be on the game is probably like the biggest deal.
Well, thank you for coming on the show today.
Thank you for inviting me.
With $250,000 and All-Star Weekend tickets on the line, the best 2K Pro-Am teams are doing all that they can to make it into the 2K17 All-Star Esports Tournament. And guys, qualification is not easy. One team who managed to qualify is For Your Eyes Only. And today joining us in studio, we have Kid Kuda, the team owner.
Hey.
So tell me about how your team got started. I know it was a last minute thing.
Yeah, so it was just about a week ago is when we formed the team. I hit up a few of my friends and I was like, look, this tournament's like, it's a week away. Let's see if we can just start up a team. These players that I was playing with were actually...
It's the 2K Sports pregame show, brought to you by Kia.
Welcome, everyone, to this 2K Sports broadcast live from the capital city of California, Sacramento. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Doris Burke and Greg Anthony. We'll be catching up in a bit from our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. The Cleveland Cavaliers come into this one following a loss to the Trailblazers in Portland. And that was a real body blow for them. They got taken apart both offensively and defensively.
How about the shooting percentage, though, in the low 30s? That tells you all you need to know.
I think indicative of some breakdowns in their offensive execution. You don't create any open looks, and they couldn't make the ones they were taking.
And let's go straight over to David Aldridge for a report before the tip-off. Hey, Dave.
Well, LeBron James, of course, is one of the greatest players to ever play the game, but he remains one of the most team-first superstars you'll find. He said a lot of people misconstrue what it takes to win, just scoring or going out and trying to will it yourself. It's a team game, and you have to rely on your teammates as well. And he remains, with his vision and passing, among the best at spreading the wealth. Kevin?
Great, great stuff, D.A. Thanks. Well, at this point of the season, Doris, near the midway point, teams really now talking about what they're going to be and where they may go from where they are right now.
Well, I think you have a good familiarity with your roster. You know the strengths and weaknesses of your team. If there's aspects you need to shore up, you might be eyeing as the trade deadline approaches. You definitely have a handle on how you win and who you are.
Our coaches sometimes, and maybe this is true with every sport, too close to it, where sometimes they need to step back and get perspective? Do they seek outside counsel, just another pair of eyes on a team and the feel of the team?
I think just like in life, you need truth tellers in your world, right? And you want people who are as good, or to be honest, you hope that you surround yourself with people that are better than you, and you know your true friends are the ones who tell you the truth.
I don't have many friends. All fueled up and ready to go. Brought to you by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. And so in the game for the Cavaliers, LeBron and Love, the two superstar forwards. Kyrie Irving is out there with DeAndre Liggins, and it's Thompson in at the center position. That one misses, so he goes 1 for 2.
And for a franchise that competed for the Western Conference Championship a number of years ago, it's really been a lot of turmoil for quite a while. I mean, the Kings have had ownership changes, coaching changes, personnel changes, front office changes. I mean, that's been the one constant, is the fact that they consistently are in change mode.
Here's James, following the basket by DeMarcus Cousins. Thompson, a screen on Gay. James dishes to Thompson. A putback, and Love with a second chance points.
Boy, how do you like the determination from Love right there? You have to put a body on this guy whenever a shot goes up.
Takes the 13-footer, and it's good off the back of the rim and in. On defense, Sacramento. They put up a nice win against Detroit the last time out.
They drew a lot of fouls in that game, guys, and that was the one area that really stood out when you watched it.
When your key contributors sit the bench because of foul trouble, obviously that's a problem, and they got plenty of freebies from the charity stripe.
Now, here is Lawson, following the miss by Kevin Love. And there's the call on James. That's his first foul.
Ref's calling it close already as he picks up a quick early foul.
About a minute and a half through the first quarter. Here's Cousins. Bucket is good. Cousins has got his second bucket tonight.
I tell you what, guys, it's going to be a tough day on this defense if he's got the A game rolling tonight.
Right, he's got it rolling so far. Just the kind of start he was hoping to get off to.
Now here's James. 20 points for him last game against the Trailblazers in Portland.
The other thing, he really changed the pace of the game when you consider how many free throws he shot. Drawing fouls is an art, and really he has mastered that part of the game.
And here is Barnes after LeBron James hitting the three. Off the screen, Cousins, no good.
And really, despite that miss, they've had a solid start offensively.
Now here's James, and he's currently averaging more than 26 points a game. Such a force. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
Now you think about Kevin Love deciding that he would return to Cleveland, a shiny new five-year, $110 million contract. He had to sit with LeBron first and discuss how he could perhaps do more to help the team win. Let's remember, this was a big-time guy in Minnesota.
And he makes the first. And Kevin Love knew when he joined the Cavaliers that it would be in a different role. Instead of being the go-to guy he was in Minnesota, he is now more or less the third option.
Yeah, and I think Kevin, obviously, for the Cavs, you want to make sure you can try to continue to feature him offensively, even if that's by staggering minutes with LeBron's. You want to keep him engaged and take advantage of his talents. I think greatness requires sacrifice, and Kevin Love has fit beautifully as a secondary scorer here. He spaces the floor with that shooting ability, willing to hit the offensive glass, and he's become a player who can score efficiently without dominating the ball.
Lawson's against Irving. Love with the screen for Irving. Passes it to Love. Six to shoot. Irving with it. Guarded now by DeMarcus Cousins. Once again off the mark by Cleveland. And at the same time that Love creates breathing room for others with his shooting, Doris, it's clear he doesn't want to be reduced to just being a floor spacer.
Well, and I don't think, Kevin, that's the best role for him either. He's a player who can work from the elbow and on the post. He makes plays for himself and those around him. They've got to run the ball through him at times to get him touches and allow him to make plays.
Now Barnes, following the three-point attempt by Kevin Love. Collison, no good. Irving with it. 11 points for him in that last game against Portland. He feeds it to LeBron. Back to Irving from 12 feet out. That doesn't go in either for Irving. Lawson outside. Cousins with a screen for Lawson. Pass to Cousins. Three-pointer. LeBron grabs the miss. For Cleveland, they've gone just 2 of 7 so far. A little bit of a slow start for them. Outside Irving. Back to LeBron. It's a pick by Love. That one's off. He's now 1 for 2. Sacramento's gone 0 of 2 from deep here. Feeds to Lawson. Good ball movement here by the Kings. Collison with another miss. Cavaliers trailing. Outside Irving. Again, Irving missing.
And they had some botched coverage that turned into no coverage.
To the middle. Here's Gay. Misses in close.
Outstanding defense. No one wants to get in front of that guy when he's around the rim, but he did a great job there.
And the basket by Liggins.
How good is King James at spreading the floor, involving everyone on the offensive end?
Lawson kicks to Gay. Inside, Cousins. A good finish at the rack off the slick feet. Cousins has got 10.
And I need to see some more assertiveness out of these defenders.
Irving kicks to James. Love, great positioning on the putback.
You love the consistent effort from Kevin Love. It makes him one of the best offensive rebounders in the league. You can't let him get free putbacks.
Now here's Lawson. His last outing, he had 8 points. Kicks to Cousins. Puts it up from 12. And no good that time. Good D by Irving. James against Gay. Free throw line jump shot. Another miss by James.
You know, it's been hard for him to find the range this quarter, but I do like his aggressiveness.
And Cousins gets it to go.
Both teams trading punches back and forth. This thing's like a heavyweight fight.
The best may be yet to come. It's this kind of back-and-forth battle. You almost know this thing's going down to a special finish. You know, I think one thing, when LeBron returned to Cleveland, it was such a change in team culture, right? That military background that he sort of absorbed in Miami, he tried to bring that back to Cleveland. Now they're an outlier, but I think LeBron wanted the Cavs to move in that direction.
He's checked in for Ty Lawson. Iman Shumpert has checked in for Cleveland. Cleveland's gone just 1-of-4 from three-point range here in the first. And LeBron last season made his case publicly known about the need for the Cavs to go in early, go home late, and put in work. You think that helped?
Well, I think he was doing whatever he could, and at times it may have rubbed people the wrong way. And I think we have seen a change, though. Players are working harder. They understand the level of commitment needed to compete for a title. Well, you talk about a dominant quarter. Everything's coming up points for this guy.
Here's Irving, a dependable source of points for his team, averages just under 24 points a game. And Thompson gets it to go.
Yeah, there are several ways that Thompson can be a factor on the offensive end, and he is still adding to that arsenal.
They set the pick. Barnes sets a screen for Collison. The dish to Gay. Here's Cousins, and there are the Kings with another bucket.
Well, there's no question about why they're up. His accuracy has been phenomenal tonight.
Well, Cleveland shooting 40% here in the early stages. LeBron kicks to Thompson. Good, and the assist goes to James. Thompson's got it all tied up now for the Cavs.
And a nice job here early of establishing an inside presence.
Collison, the pass to a follow. Back to Collison. He's looking for Cousins and finds him. And count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the free throw line.
Well, you talk about a dominant quarter. Everything's coming up points for this guy.
And some changes here for the Kings. Anthony Tolliver. He's checked in for Barnes. And it's Ben McLemore in for Rudy Gay. Channing Frye's checked in for Cleveland. Korver comes in for Kevin Love. The Cavaliers trail by three. And here is James. He kicks it to Frye. Pass to Irving. Five to shoot. Goes up on the wing. And again, it's Cleveland.
Irving, one of those guys that will make a shot no matter how well you defend him. That's just how good he is.
Collison kicks to Cousins. That one good for two. Cousins has got 21 in the game.
And of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is just smash mouth physical basketball, guys.
Now here's Irving. Let's the three fly. Again, Irving missing.
He's been so inconsistent from the field, and that makes it hard for these guys to catch up.
McLemore dishes to Cousins. And DeMarcus Cousins, such a polarizing figure for coaches and fans alike. And this is dating back to his college days, even at Kentucky.
Yeah, maturing some, but obviously that fire burns bright within him. His passion is what helps fuel that production, especially when you start comparing him to other true centers.
And that one falls for DeMarcus Cousins. And Cousins drops them both. Doris, of course, you played point guard. You know all about that position. You know all about the game. We're seeing a renaissance, in fact, at that point guard position right now in the NBA. But just for the moment, if you will, talk about the mentality
of playing point guard.
Well, I think the most important aspect of this is you are the caretaker of your team, and caretaker implies many things. First and foremost, you've got to be intimately familiar with every position on the floor. You've got to understand your job and then the jobs of everybody else. And then, as importantly, it's your responsibility to make everybody feel good. So if your power forward hasn't touched the ball in 6 or 7 trips and he's a main scorer, you find that. The position forces you to take a broad perspective of the game.
Kuvis checked in for Sacramento. Temple comes in for Darren Collison. Temple gets the bucket.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Now Irving, from outside the arc, he scores the basket. That's field goal number 3 for him.
Boy, when Irving is in rhythm from distance like he is, turn the lights out. Defense has no answer.
Now the feed to McLemore. There's the pass to Tolliver. A follow outside. He dishes it to Temple. Lots of room. Cavaliers with the rebound. This game against Sacramento is the first time they've met this year.
Yeah, and they swept this matchup the 2 times they played last year. They held the advantage on paper and on the court.
Well, a year ago, there was a big gap in talent between the 2 teams. But changes are always made, and we'll see how they match up this time around.
The Kings leading. This is to Tolliver. 13 feet away. No good off the front iron.
They were right there on him, guys. When you take away space from a shooter, it can rattle and force a miss like they did there.
LeBron passes to Shumpert and stolen by Aflalo. 1:16 left in the first. McLemore, no good.
He really had no excuse not to make that shot. Hopefully it won't shake his confidence.
Irving kicks to Fry, and he hits it to tie the game up.
Yeah, guys, that takes vision and timing to put it on time and on target.
Passes it to McLemore. He feeds it to Tolliver. A follow outside. Here's the screen. Trying his luck deep. It's hauled in by Fry. Temple's gone 1 of 3 from the field here. The shot. James, no good. The Kings shooting quite well in these early minutes, 55%. It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. A follow outside. Here's Temple, covered by LeBron, trying to get back on track. And that one comes up a bit short. Another miss by James. It's all tied in Sacramento. Don't go anywhere, folks. We'll be back in just a moment. And of course, as we've always seen with LeBron James, it's not just about the numbers, but his tremendous, tremendous leadership.
I put all the pressure on me to be better and come through for my teammates. This is the position I put myself in. It's the position I put our team in. And as the leader and the guy that goes out there and make things happen, that's the way it's going to be.
That there is straight talk from a man who does not pretend. LeBron James with a textbook example how to take responsibility and lead.
And Kevin, that's why he is the king. He doesn't say, hey, I'm just one of the 5 guys. No, he knows who he is and what he has to do. Bottom line, he's the man. Climb on my shoulders and I'm going to take you to the promised land.
Up to this point, a closely contested game as we start the second quarter. And for the Kings guys, what jumps out to you stats-wise?
a lot of times the team that owns the paint is going to come away with the victory, and that's what they've done here thus far.
You know, clearly a point of emphasis for them to attack the rim. They're not settling for perimeter shots.
Holly Stein is out there with Kosta Kupis. Then it's Garrett Temple. Then it's Lawson. And it's Caspi in at the small forward. That's the five to begin the second quarter for the Kings. Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Well, when Kevin Love was in Minnesota, he developed into a three-point shooter, but he said, I know I'm not a stretch four. I'm a post player that can shoot. It's like Kevin McHale used to tell me, just go where they ain't. I try to space the floor as best as I can. Kevin?
Thanks, DA, and spacing so crucial in today's game.
Oh, no defense right there for that shot from Irving. Released so quick, especially off the pass.
Lawson dishes to Gay. The fader. And the shot goes in. Guys, seven times the lead has changed hands here now.
Yeah, and that number should easily top double figures before it's over.
Now, here is Irving. Wallace with it. Now Lawson defending. Outside jumper. Here's Love. Drops one in from the wing. Love's got eight.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agendas.
And you think of the great outside shooting of the Cavs. Doris, how much of that is the brilliance of LeBron James creating those shots for his teammates?
Well, you hit the nail on the head, Kevin. LeBron is not only one of the most devastating slashers and finishers, but his passing might be his greatest strength. Pinpoint bullet passes that zip into shooters' hands before the defense can react. And you look at his shooting percentage on his passes, sky high. You know, probably could have set that screen with a little more force, but it got him just enough room to be able to finish.
Lawson kicks to Gay. The shot, no good. Jefferson with some nice D. To the paint. And Jefferson throws it down.
Yeah, guys, not sure how many big men could have found that open man that quick. Great play from Kevin Love there.
Lawson the pass to Caspi. Down low. And with that shot, the Cleveland lead is cut down to just one on the bucket from Gay.
You know, rough start for him, but he seems to have turned the corner here in the second period.
Irving kicks to Love. Thompson sets the pick for Love. Cleveland moving it around. He doesn't hit that one. And Sacramento will go the other way with it. Caspi dishes to Cauley Stein. And stolen by Love. Here's Irving. Here's Thompson. And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a three-point play.
You can see Thompson does a good job carving out space for himself to secure that board.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight. Cavaliers making a switch here.
One shot.
Liggins is checked in. Thompson no good on the free throw. And Tristan Thompson has improved his scoring efficiency, Doris, every season in the NBA.
Yeah, I mean, listen, Kevin, this is not a go-to scorer, more of a garbage buckets type player, but he's learning how to be effective. And he's also improving as a decision maker. Last season, his best ever assist-to-turnover ratio.
Four on the clock. Goes up from the top of the key. No good from Lawson. The Cavaliers leading by three. Irving with it. Now Lawson defending, and the shot goes down. 12 points for Love.
Yeah, and their shooting really starting to pick up here in the second.
Gay kicks to Cauley Stein. Pass to Temple. To the paint. It's deflected. It's stolen by Jefferson. And Liggins kicks to Love. Wants to get it to Irving and does. And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a three-point play.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
Some changes for Sacramento. DeMarcus Cousins comes in for Cauley Stein. And it's Collison in for Ty Lawson. For Cleveland, they have made three of their first five foul shots tonight.
Kyrie Irving, one of the most explosive scorers in the league, perhaps the best crossover in the entire NBA. Lightning quick in either direction, strings them together to leave defenders grasping at thin air.
Now, here's Cousins. Had a 24-point outing in their last game against Detroit.
You know what else impressed me? How infectious his tenacity was. Simply a wrecking ball on the boards, collected huge amounts of rebounds.
Talk about Irving scoring. He can go for 50 on any given night.
Well, Kevin, listen, he's got the pull-up threes. He can finish around the rim. He's a shoot-first point guard and not a bad fit playing alongside a point forward like LeBron. Looked like it might drop for him, and you know, that has to frustrate him just a bit. That's one of his favorite spots on the floor.
Screen by Jefferson. Here's Liggins. Here's Love. And that one goes in as he is fouled.
Basket's
It'll
good.
Be 3 points if he converts at the line.
They are just killing him on the interior.
For Cleveland, they have made 4 free throws from the line and missed 2.
And on the season, you know, they're hitting about 76%, which is a decent rate.
Doris, we see a lot of teams in the NBA push the tempo right now. As a former point guard, did you prefer playing at that kind of pace, at a faster pace?
Well, first of all, I grew up a Showtime Lakers fan. So they played at, you know, breakneck pace. Magic out in the open floor. James Worthy on one wing. Kareem running the lane line. I loved playing at a faster pace. I mean, for players, you're out in space. You're able to show off your athleticism. The best part of my game was my handles, Kevin.
Right. Well, people always say that when, you know, if you're playing basketball, they're quarterback in the offense. If you're playing football, you're the point guard of the offense. So it seems to me like those two positions are really the same position, maybe the most important position in all of sports.
No, I think so. I don't think there's any question, because the ball is in your hands and you are an extension of the head coach, whether you're talking football or basketball.
Quick thinking people play that position. That's a compliment for you, Doris.
I appreciate that.
Kevin Love with a strong contribution so far in this one.
He's just really a one-man wrecking crew down low. And with this timeout, they've got to make some adjustments because he's been steady inside.
And a moment here to look at the numbers for Rudy Gay. Averaging about 18 points per, 6 rebounds, and 3 assists. And he brings that offensive firepower to the team. Scoring just comes naturally.
Sacramento with the ball. They trail by 11. Here's Cousins, and the bucket counts, and he's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a 3-point play.
And after his last game, really not surprised to see him as hot as he is here tonight.
Yeah, I mean, he really carried the momentum from the last game right to this one. He is rolling.
He is 3 for 3 from the free throw line.
He struggled mightily at the free throw line in their last game.
The Cavaliers leading by 8. Now, here is Irving. 13 points in the game. And the rejection by Cousins. Sacramento moving it around. And Tristan Thompson gets the whistle that time. That's his 3rd foul of the game.
Boy, now you have to think about pulling him. 3 fouls already in this half. A 4th would be inexcusable.
Barnes, he's checked in for the Kings. Screen by Cousins. And the wide open shot from Collison. Again, the miss by the Kings. Here's the break. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good. He'll go to the line.
Shooting one.
And Kyrie Irving, the MVP of Team USA back in the 2014 World Cup. You know, Doris, when the lights are brightest, he's usually at his best.
And that's what you hope for, Kevin, right? This is a guy who's won the 3-point shootout. He's won an All-Star MVP and the Rising Stars MVP. Elite competition seems to bring out the best in him. And when he heats up, he can take over.
Now, here's Collison. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. Sacramento again missing. Cleveland leading by 11. Left side, Love. Good, and the assist goes to Irving. Irving's got 5 assists in the game.
He's been lights out here in the second, and that's after a pretty good showing in the first.
Here's Gay. An 11-point game for him in the win against Detroit.
And it wasn't only his scoring. The intensity on defense. He nabbed 3 steals that night.
And Rudy Gay, extremely versatile, has the size and athleticism to play a number of positions. He produces, but for some reason, you know, Greg, people always seem to want more out of the guy.
Yeah, some of the disrespect I think he deals with is because he hasn't played on a lot of winning teams. Greater efficiency and tougher defense are a couple of areas where he's still trying to improve.
And the Kings making a change here. McLemore is checked in. And a switch here also for Cleveland. Korver's checked in. So he gets them both.
They've hit every one of their free throws here in the second quarter. Very important when you're trailing.
Screen by Jefferson. Korver kicks to Love. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
And you know, if you foul Love, he's going to make you pay at the free throw line.
He's shooting free throws, number 4 and 5 here.
Now, gentlemen, two shots. Two shots.
That one is off. Anthony Tolliver. He's checked in for Rudy Gay. And Cleveland with a change here, too. LeBron, he's checked in for Thompson. And the second free throw, good. Doris, you've interviewed so many coaches over the years. Which coaches do you enjoy interviewing the most?
Well, I have to say my classmate, Billy Donovan.
No kidding.
We were both point guards in the class of 87. I like to tell Billy he was the second best one in that class, in fact. I do enjoy.
I bet he enjoys that, too. He's a good man, isn't he?
Huh? He is, no question about it. And because he's new to the league, he's not objecting quite yet to the ad nauseum questions we tend to ask over and over.
How about quickly talking with Greg Popovich of San Antonio, which is always a challenge, whether you're calling the game or you're on the sideline.
I want you to understand something. When I'm walking over to Greg Popovich, I want you to understand that my heart is pounding. I'm probably sweating.
No, come on.
And I'm trying not to shake.
Oh, come on. That's against everything you are. I know that. It's always good conversation, though. And the dunk by Jefferson.
Ooh, that's as forceful a finish as you're ever going to see out of this guy.
Well, gee, it adds now to their lead in spectacular fashion.
You know, and I'm not seeing any urgency out of this defense, especially considering the deficit in the score.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat.
Korver, good. Collison with it. Looking for his first basket still in this one. Timeout called by the Kings.
30.
Checked in for Cleveland. And a chance to now check out the scoring distribution between the front court and the back court players tonight for the Kings.
And despite the deficit, you know, their front line has battled and provided a sizable majority of their offense. They are holding up their end. They just need that back court to step up.
It's stolen by Korver. And here we go. Fast break. Korver's got it. The pull-up. LeBron passes to Jefferson. Good D by Barnes.
That's what we call good defense in the paint, worth its weight in gold.
Yeah, he has the innate ability to change shots. What a competitor.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well. And that assist got him a little nod from his teammate after that one.
Outside Collison. Feeds it to Cousins. And the three off target. The Cavaliers leading by 16. LeBron with it. Picked up by Collison. LeBron dishes to Jefferson. It's stolen by McLemore. That's a two from Korver and misses it off the right side of the rim.
And honestly, not real happy with the shot selection on that one.
He knows it. He just got locked into scoring mode and couldn't get out of it.
Barnes can't get it to go. Cleveland's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. LeBron kicks to Fry. Outside for Jefferson. The dish to Liggins. Six on the shot clock. Launches it. Sacramento grabs the miss. Tolliver's got three rebounds now in this one. Barnes can't get it to go. Cavaliers shooting a sweet 57% clip in quarter number two. LeBron James on the wing. The 15-footer, good. LeBron's got his third basket of the night.
Well, LeBron's going to put in work from the mid-range if you start to give him that kind of space.
Collison kicks to Cousins. Back to Collison. And they get it. It's rebounded by Jefferson.
Wow, this defense is blanking him down the stretch, and that's certainly hurting his team's chances.
And he can time his passes so perfectly. Wow, what an assist.
And Sacramento has possession. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
And they need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Collison kicks to Cousins. To the middle. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two.
And now a look at LeBron James here. The last 10 or so games, he has been remarkable. Sixth in scoring, 14th in assists, and he's as opportunistic as anybody defensively, ranking among the top 15 league-wide in steals per game.
First free throw is good. Kuvis checked in for Sacramento. Flalo comes in for Matt Barnes. Iman Shumpert is checked in for Cleveland. That one is no good. And you look at LeBron's career, he's been cast in so many roles. The child prodigy, Doris, the chosen one, the villain, the champion, now the savior. So much of that is media creation, as we know. At this point in his career, does he care, you think, Doris, what people even say about him?
I think he's certainly conscious of his brand, Kevin, but I think LeBron's at a point in his career where it's a little bit devil may care. The Miami move was so criticized. Those rings don't come with any asterisks, though, right? I mean, he realizes that as long as he wins, the rest is just noise.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
Kicks to McLemore. Pass to Kuffis. Aflalo dishes to Collison. Shot off the pick. That's his first basket of the game. 1 for 6 and looking for more. The Cavaliers leading by 20. Here's Shumpert. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. James, and off the glass. That one's good. And he's now got the double-double. 10 points and 11 rebounds. Collison kicks to McLemore. It's Kuffis atop the key. Aflalo with it. He's picked up by James. And there's the feed to Collison. Just 5 to shoot. Fires from deep. Second chance shot. Got a hand on it. And he gets it back. A nice shot by Kufis. Kufis has got 4 points now in the quarter. Here's Shumpert. And poor shot selection there. Not a high percentage look for him. A dominating first half of basketball, and so far hasn't been close. Cleveland ahead, running away with it. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks a lot. Kyrie, what were you all focusing on coming into the game tonight?
I come out with a intense focus and intensity that other teams can't match. Just doing whatever it takes to keep our tempo. Guys are in a great rhythm when we have a great tempo, so just trying to get everybody involved and do whatever it takes to win.
Well, we'll see if you can keep playing at your pace in the second half. Thanks a lot. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks for the great interview, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of basketball following halftime.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
And we hope you've enjoyed our first half of action. I'm Ernie Johnson welcoming you back. Shaquille O'Neal is right there. Kenny the Jet Smith is right there. And this here is the halftime report. What a performance so far tonight by Kevin Love. He had 18 points, 6 rebounds, and 1 steal. Kenny, your thoughts. How are the Cavaliers playing?
Well, we can't look past the huge contribution their bench has provided. They've got this lead mainly because of the injection of energy and offense that they got from their reserves. That's what a coach wants to see. I'm guessing the minutes will be spread out a little bit in the second half.
Shaq, what's your take on Sacramento?
Way too soft in the paint defensively. They were all late on their rotations. Obviously, that's a recipe for getting cooked. And you know I like eating that barbecue chicken. They got to do better, Ernie.
That's it for now, as the second half is just about ready to go. We, and I mean the three of us, will be right here after the final buzzer.
A nighttime glimpse of the Tower Bridge, one of the landmarks here in Sacramento. Welcome back, everyone, to the capital of California. And as we welcome you back, we begin our second half. So far, not a tightly contested game, guys, but you know, anything can happen. You look at DeMarcus Cousins in this game, he has been everywhere.
Yeah, you know, one of the things about the truly greats of our game is that sometimes you get spoiled because of how consistent they can be, and so far another big scoring night for him.
Amazing, because they're always a focal point for the defense and always looking for ways to take him out of the game, and that didn't happen in this first half.
Checking out the group for Tyronn Lue to start the second half. Love and Thompson, the hard rebounding post pair. DeAndre Liggins out there with Kyrie Irving. And it's James in at the three spot. Cousins, no good. The Cavaliers leading by 20. Here's Thompson, and a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two. It's on DeMarcus Cousins.
Yeah, Thompson not really the guy who's going to punish you consistently for sending him to the free throw line.
And Tristan Thompson, one of the premier offensive rebounders in the game, second overall, in fact, in offensive rebounds last year.
Well, Kevin, this is a guy who makes his living around the rim. He runs rim to rim, terrific on the pick and roll. He's a smart cutter, does a good job lurking on the baseline for drop-offs or second chance points.
No good at the stripe this time. Second misses also. Gay outside from the high post. Thompson with the rebound. Thompson's got 6 rebounds in the game. Goes up from the top of the key. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up, and 2 shots coming up. And for LeBron, he's got a lot of miles on him. Some studies have shown players who come to the league at a young age and, of course, play a lot of minutes end up experiencing earlier and sharper declines in their 30s. Do you think that could be the case for LeBron?
Well, obviously, Kevin, we've seen him deal with some back issues over the course of his career. He took that mid-season break back in 2015, the longest absence of his career. But listen, come on, LeBron's been an iron man. He's learning to pick his spots and to manage some of that wear and tear.
And James drills them both.
LeBron James is consistent enough at the line where he'll make you pay most times if you're going to send him there.
Lawson kicks to Cousins. They set the pick. Back to Lawson. Screen by Cousins. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one, drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there. The Kings have been coming through at the charity stripe. They've made 7 of their 8 attempts.
Two shots.
Two shots.
And the first one drops. Lawson hits them both. Cleveland leading by 20. Love outside. Here in this third quarter, just over a minute play. Thompson, a screen on Lawson. No good from Irving. The Kings shooting the ball at 42%. Lawson the pass to Gay. Here's Cousins, and there's 2 points. Working on the glass, paying off that time. Cousins has got 30.
Boy, as we reach the latter stages, he's been in a ridiculous groove. They simply can't get over the hump.
The screen from Thompson. James kicks to Love. And the three off target.
Oh, that's a tough 3-point try when you've got the defense right there.
How about the closeout? Gave no room to operate. Great effort.
Now here's Collison. He's playing a pretty big role for him at the offensive end, averaging about 12.5 points a game. Irving dishes to James. Love outside. He kicks to Irving. Lock at 6. That's in there. Love with the assist. And that's now 19 points for Kyrie Irving.
I'll tell you, when Irving is hot, there isn't much you can do to slow him down. Pretty much have to ride out the storm, guys.
Gay outside. Back to Cousins. The 8-footer. And it falls over the rim and in. Cousins has got 32 points in the game.
You know, completely in rhythm. He's been deadly from a number of spots, but too many of their guys aren't playing well enough.
It's a pick by Love to the paint and stolen by Cousins. Lawson outside. Second half of play, and we're 3 minutes into the third here. Gay outside. 5 to shoot. The Kings need to get off a shot here. Here's Lawson, and the shot falls short this time. The Cavaliers leading by 19. Love the pass to Irving. Takes the 3. Offensive rebound. James with the putback. And there's Thompson putting it right back in. Thompson's got 8 points.
Yeah, I think the activity level that Tristan Thompson plays with on missed shots is something every NBA player can learn from.
He does not look happy. Their defensive rebounding has been putrid, and they're giving up a ton of second chance points.
on changes for Sacramento. Cauley Stein, he's checked in for Barnes. And Garrett Temple, subbed in for Darren Collison. Third quarter action and just under 3.5 minutes have gone. And here's Lawson. He's averaging just around 8.5 points a game. Now the pass to Cousins. Irving with the steal. Here's Liggins. He dishes it to Irving. The screen from Thompson. Five on the clock. Lawson outside. To the paint, deflects the pass, and stolen by Love. Irving from long range. Here's Thompson, and the rejection by Cousins. And Temple kicks to Lawson. Dishes it to Cousins. And there's the call on James. That'll be his second foul of the game. Caspi, he's checked in for the Kings.
Omri Caspi.
Lawson outside. Pass to Cauley Stein. Fader on the way. Goes back up. And the layup is good.
This guy is getting after it on the offensive glass. Nice job to cash in on the second chance points.
Lawson against Irving. He feeds it to James. Good, and the assist goes to Irving. Irving's got his sixth assist on the night.
Don't give LeBron James a lane to the hoop because he will be ruthless in his attack. He takes advantage anytime he sees daylight.
Here's Temple. Taking a look at his stats, he's averaging around 7.5 points a game. Down to five on the shot clock. Expanding his range. Cavaliers with the rebound. Thompson's got 9 rebounds now tonight. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot 2.
Yeah, easy call.
The Cavaliers have made 9 free throws in the game, 14 attempts. That free throw, no good. Shumpert is checked in for James. Good on the second free throw. King shooting pretty terrible here in the third quarter at around 30%. Lawson dishes to Gay. Inside. And there's the 3-second violation. And here is the shot chart as we see how things are going.
And this is what happens when you are having a tremendous offensive game. They are getting great looks and knocking down shots all over the floor. I don't think we're going to see them deviate from this approach from here on out. They've got the recipe for success.
Cleveland leading by 22. Now Irving. He's got 19. Again, and there's Thompson putting it right back in. Thompson's got 10 points in the game.
And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
Timeout called by the Kings. Kyrie Irving really making a difference here.
This is just a night where he's decided to take control, and I think from a defensive perspective, you look at this timeout right now, you try to figure out a way to at least get him out of rhythm.
and the Cavaliers making a change here. Korver's checked in.
And let's check out the stats for Lawson. His last 10 games, getting around 12 points a game, 3 assists, and 2 rebounds. And you look at those numbers, not bad, but guys, I think he can do better, and he knows it.
There's the pick. Here's Gay. And off the front iron, and in it goes. He's got 10.
There's no question he's one of the more gifted offensive players in this league. More evidence of that right here.
The screen from Thompson. And on the way from Irving for 3. Another miss by Irving.
If he were shooting even a little better, they would have a much bigger lead.
And for the big 3 in Cleveland, LeBron, Kyrie Irving, and Kevin Love, it took some time to develop their chemistry.
Well, as Coach Lou said to them, Kevin, hey, it's not always going to be your night. Encourage them to feed the hot hand, and in particular, told Kevin Love, you're a bad man, demand the ball. And I think once he got integrated into the offense, they got better.
And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up.
Well, you guys know, Love knows how to find the contact when he wants to. Good job getting to the line.
He's had 5 chances at the line, gone 4 for 5. First one falls for him. And the Kings will go for a different look here. Kuvis checked in for Willie Cauley-Stein. Tolliver comes in for Rudy Gay. Aaron Aflalo, he's checked in for Garrett Temple. And McLemore subbed in for Ty Lawson. Channing Frye's checked in for the Cavaliers. Both free throws good from Kevin Love. Here's McLemore. He's averaging around 5.5 points a game. Pass to Tolliver. And a big bounce off the rim, but it sinks right in. Tolliver's got his first basket of the night.
And they're passing the ball very crisply here.
Now here's Irving, guarded by McLemore. And it's Irving missing.
And he's been way off the mark this quarter. It's been ugly.
And there are the Kings with another bucket.
Well, that's Aflalo's rise and fire ability, that he can get a glimpse of the hoop before dropping it in.
Now, here is Irving. He's got 19. Off the pick, and the jumper is on the mark. Irving's got 21 in the game.
You know, probably could have set that screen with a little more force, but it got him just enough room to be able to finish.
And Caspi kicks to McLemore. And stolen by Kyrie Irving. Here's Love. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here.
Two shots, gentlemen.
Two. In the game, he shot 6 of 7 from the line.
And what a performance he's put in at the free throw line.
First free throw is good. Analytics certainly have jumped up in their usage around the NBA. Doris, how do you feel it's been used? Is it here to stay? Where's it going?
You know, it's been such a fascinating discussion amongst players and coaches. Coaches, by and large, will tell you, yes, we like analytics, but I have to coach by feel. And I don't think you can overvalue or undervalue either one. You're never going to take a step back, Kevin. The metrics of it are too important. In terms of how we're able to track the movements of players, they haven't worked hard enough today. We can go hard again tomorrow. I think it's all important, but I think the best organizations are the ones who look at things in its totality.
It's taught me about the game. I mean, and the things that maybe I've never thought about
like
as a
what?
Fan. Well, like, you know, the success of jump shots between 10 and 16 feet. How many times the guy goes to his right as opposed to his left. What his favorite block is to set up in. How much he's been used in practice during the week. where they're going to go defensively, where the weak spots are. Just different things to consider, which gives you a taste of what coaches and organizations go through during a game, during preparation, and getting ready for their opponent.
Yeah.
There's so much to consider, and you can be overloaded by analytics, too.
That's, you were sitting there describing that, and I thought these are all excellent points. At what point does it become overload? At what point are you able to filter out the necessary things? I imagine that's an art.
Mm-hmm. Now, here is Irving. He's got 21. Outside Korver. Left side, Love. And that one hits back iron.
He should have made that, guys. The defense was okay, but he had no excuse not to finish.
Aflalo, no good. The Cavaliers leading by 22. Love kicks to jumper. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it three.
Yeah, the determination there from Shumpert was something else. Took the foul, converts the basket. Beautiful.
The Kings making a switch here. Collison's out there. And Kyle Korver in 2015 winning the Sportsmanship Award. And more importantly, his first All-Star appearance at the age of 33.
Yeah, pretty rare to see that. But credit his dedication. He continues to work on his game, work on his body, and he gets better and better.
Out of bounds.
Not content to be a shooting specialist. He wants to have a complete game.
Richard Jefferson, he's checked in for the Cavaliers. They've shared the load offensively.
And guys, they put the defense on their heels. You can see right now they're trying to react. And that's what you want when you're in a rhythm offensively. And you don't want to give up that kind of look too often.
Tolliver, no good off the front iron. Cleveland controlling the game. They lead by 24, their biggest margin. Love with the bucket.
Phenomenal choice by K. Love to go with the pull-up jumper. Just knows how to exploit the D.
Sacramento's gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. And McLemore kicks to Tolliver. Feeds to McLemore. It's stolen by Jefferson. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
Wow, wow, he got whacked on that one. Shouldn't be much debate there.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
Yeah, he's averaging 80% from the line, and he has been as steady as they come at the strike.
Free throw good, Jefferson. Matt Barnes has checked in for Anthony Tolliver. And both free throws good for Jefferson. We've got 1:18 left in the third quarter. Collison, the pass to Kufis. The dish to McLemore. Back to Kufis. And he can't stop the run as he misses.
Plus 8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Love dishes to Korver. Kicks it to Shumpert. In the corner, it's Jefferson. Second chance shot. No good from Fry.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
Outside Collison. Pass to Barnes. All sorts of time. The shot's good. Collison making the play.
Perfect screen there. Set him up with a terrific look.
Not the strongest play defensively, though. I mean, he was taken out by that screen far too easily.
Now here's Korver. He has 6. About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Outside jumper. Here's Love. The Cavaliers again can't hit. And McLemore kicks to Collison. They set the pick. With 1 on the clock. Oh, a monumental buzzer beater.
What a thrilling shot for one team and a heartbreaker for the other.
Oh, that's the type of clutch player he sees himself as. Boy, can he deliver.
welcome back as we get ready to start the fourth quarter. Not exactly a nail biter here, but you never know. The Cavaliers shooting 47%, pretty solid. Cauley Stein is out there with Caspi. Then it's Lawson. Then there's Kufis, and it's Temple in a two-guard. So that's the five in the game for Sacramento. Here's McCray. Shakes off the strong D and gets to the bucket for two. McCray has got the fourth quarter going with the first basket of the period here for the Cavs. Here's Temple, the feed to Kufis. He kicks it to Casper. Well, with teams making their playoff push, you know, parity between the teams is the biggest goal of all the leagues. The NBA more than tripling revenue share. The little guys are in much better position now than they were a few years ago, maybe even more competitive now than they were a couple years ago.
That would have been like investing in Kevin Harlan's stock 20 years ago.
You'd be on the streets. You'd be in trouble.
I do think as a professional organization, and this is where the NFL has mastered things, right? Everybody should have an opportunity to win your championship, and I think that's the beauty of the NBA. Every decision they make is trying to line up the ducks so that everybody is equally positioned to have a chance to win.
It can't be done overnight.
No.
And it really is a reflection maybe more on the front office than on the play of the court. It's who you've got on your team.
Kevin, I'm a big believer in this. Not only should we show the head coach's record, let's show the GM's record.
I like that. Here's Felder. Here's Fry. Cauley Stein grabs the board. Cauley Stein's got his third rebound tonight. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
Here's Temple. The putback.
You know, we talk about it all the time, guys. Those second chance buckets, always the result of that extra effort.
Here's Felder. The pass to Jefferson. Jumper off the screen. Jefferson can't get that one to fall. Sacramento's gone 0-3 so far in the fourth quarter from long range. And Temple kicks to Lawson. Play styles change, as do leagues. Doris with the influx of more overseas players in the NBA. What have you noticed in the change in play style?
Well, this is a really fascinating aspect to me, because what happens overseas is young players are forced to play with a shorter shot clock than formative years
Shoot
in the
two.
United States. And I think the reason you see Europeans so much better developed and skilled is because they're having to be multi-tooled from their earliest days. And I think that makes them more well-rounded basketball players.
That is so interesting. And I've always thought, too, the Hubie Browns, the Mike Fratellos of the world, going over there summer after summer, running clinics and exporting this great game of basketball to Europe.
I think Kevin, your point is well said, and those two guys are great friends. I think you'd be hard pressed to find someone, any individual, who's influenced more generations of basketball players than Hubie Brown.
Bravo. Bravo. Felder, the pass to Jones. And over 2.5 minutes in the books here in the fourth. That one goes. Just count it. Here's Lawson. He dishes it to Casper. Lawson outside. Passes to Cauley Stein. And stolen by Fry. Out to the wing. Puts it up from 15. Ball's knocked loose. The Kings have gone 1-5 from the field here in the fourth. A lot of misses, just the one make. Here's Temple. Dishes it to Caspi. To the paint. Here's the screen. Use that pick to get in close.
Well, the pick didn't exactly neutralize the defender, but good concentration on the finish to still get the basket.
Here's Felder. Pass to McCray. And a moment now to discuss injuries, something, Doris, that all teams have to deal with, the most players as well from time to time. Let's get your take on what's the key to staying healthy.
Well, I think obviously most professional athletes realize that they have a limited window with which to make money with their body. And so if you are smart from the time you enter the league going all the way through your career, you're doing the right things. You're getting the proper rest. You're paying attention to nutrition. You're getting massages. You're going to the chiropractor. You're taking all kinds of both proactive and preventative steps to stay healthy. From a league perspective, this is obviously crucial because they know that the players are their most important commodity. And so you're starting to see individual teams and organizations track the movements of their players, both in practice and in games. That kind of data is critical because if you see somebody wearing down, if the data is in fact telling you, okay, Dwayne Wade has run far too much in the last week, let's dial back practice. Let's sit him one game. I think the key is just continue to use data and continue to use what we now know and what we will know in the future to try to protect guys.
Andre Liggins, he's checked in for Cleveland. And Temple kicks to Tolliver. Now Casper, they set the pick. He feeds it to Lawson. Shot clock at 5. Lawson can't get that one to fall.
They're trying to cut this lead, but he's shooting them right out of it.
Here's McCray. And Liggins kicks to Jones. So nice passing by Cleveland here. Feeds to Fry. There's the 3. Jones, no luck.
That is fantastic defense on one of the best three-point shooters in the league. Didn't give him an inch of room.
Lawson kicks to Caspi. Back to Lawson. To the middle. And Cauley Stein with the basket on the assist by Lawson. Lawson's got his 7th assist of the game with that last one. Cavaliers have gone 6 of 11 since the start of the fourth quarter. Here's Felder. There's the dish to Liggins. There's the screen. Cleveland needs to get a shot off here. Here's McCray. Once again off the mark by Cleveland. The Kings have gotten only 3 of their 9 field goal attempts to go down since the end of the third. Pretty cold down the stretch. And it'll be Sacramento as it goes out of bounds. The Kings retain possession. Richardson, he's checked in for the Kings. Kicks to Lawson. A picture-perfect screenplay, and the jumper's good. Cleveland controlling the game. Here's Felder. Pass to Fry. Takes a 3. Connects from 3-point range. Fry has got 6 in the quarter.
And for a big man, Fry is one of the better 3-point shooters in the league. Downright lethal from the outside.
And Caspi kicks to Cauley Stein. There's the pick. Lawson outside. And yep, couple bounces and it falls.
You know, since halftime, he's finally started to shoot with confidence.
Here's Felder. The feed to Liggins. Lets it go from deep. And another 3 for Cleveland.
Add another triple to their second half total.
I mean, since the break, they've been unconscious from distance.
There's the pass to Cauley Stein. Richardson with it. 6 to shoot. Left side Lawson. Lets the 3 fly. The shot, no good. Cavaliers go the other way with it. Here's Felder. There's a screen. He kicks it to Fry for the 3. And it's Sacramento with the rebound. Caspi's got 4 rebounds in this game. He dishes it to Lawson. It's Cauley Stein, top of the key. Wasson outside. Passes to Richardson. Tolliver dishes to Casper. It's Richardson on the wing. Here's Cauley Stein, and he didn't get quite enough under that one.
And, you know, coaches just love players who they can count on to give that effort defensively.
Yeah, he's reliable on defense. Doesn't allow a shooter any separation to get comfortable.
Here's Felder. Here's Liggins. Cauley Stein grabs the board. Cauley Stein's got 5 rebounds tonight. To the inside. Tolliver kicks to Cauley Stein. Lawson outside. Cauley Stein passes to Lawson. Cauley Stein with the screen for Lawson. Back to Cauley Stein. The shot from the low post is good. And so here's Cleveland. Here's Felder. Outside, Jones. And that's going to be a travel.
Yeah, I guess when you're up this big, you can afford to get a little sloppy.
Aldoris, clear that the NBA has moved more and more to being a league that uses the three-pointer to its advantage. How do you feel about that direction the game is going?
Well, it's exciting. I don't think you can deny. What I wonder is, are they going to have to keep backing up the three-point line with as far back as Steph Curry and these guys seem to be shooting it? You know, the geometry of the floor seems to be changing.
It seems that way. What would you rather see, a great dunk or just this outstanding three-point shooting of like a Steph Curry? I love the shooting.
I love the shooting.
I love the
shooting.
I'm with
you. I agree with you that the skill level of these players is off the charts, and the fact that Steph Curry is literally changing the way defenses think about guarding. They're now not going to the paint to protect. They're extending to the three-point line. It is a revolution in how to guard in the league.
Why now with him and not with Ray Allen or Miller before him?
I think because of the high volume and the places on the floor within which he's doing it. As great as Ray Allen was, and he was and is the best all time in terms of number of threes made, that's not going to last long, because Steph Curry's range is step across half court, and you got to check that guy.
And team success, championships are following.
That's exactly right.
And so here's Sacramento. The Cavaliers making the shot. Barnes kicks to Cauley Stein. That one goes in. Cauley Stein's got 12 points in just the second half.
You know, very effective possession. You won't miss too many shots from that close range.
Here's Felder. Jones with the screen on Barnes. On the wing, Korver. Traps in the tray.
Just dialed in from the three-point line in this fourth quarter.
Pouring it in from deep. They have been absolutely unconscious down the stretch.
Well, guys, this was never really a contest, just a total obliteration, if you will. And you can safely say mission accomplished now for the Cavaliers.
As one-sided as it gets today, you know, there were some dominant moments in about every facet of this game for that team.
Yeah, I mean, Kevin, it's hard to think of what didn't go right for them. Game planning by the coaches, execution by the players, everything was just on target.
And so it'll boost this year's win total for them to 29.
And so they'll take the first game of the season series, a team they'll only see twice. They're certainly happy to start it off with a win. A fantastic show. And what an amazing all-around game it was for Love.
Well, what a game. Offensively, this guy was a force. Defensively, set the tone. Just bringing everything to the table and trying to get this kind of lead.
Here's Felder. Ty Lawson making his last shot. Shot clock at 6. There's the triple. Another 3 for Cleveland.
And they're not finished just yet. They're going to make sure about this win.
And that's the thing. When you fought all game, expended all your energy, you want to do everything you can to come away with the W.
Here is Caspi. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it. He'll shoot one more at the free throw line.
And this run not really doing them any good at this point, as late as it's starting to evolve.
Well, they know they've lost this one, but this is still valuable time to try and work out some of their issues.
3-point play.
There's 18 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Here's Felder. And so it's Cleveland taking care of business in this. A resounding victory for them. And, Greg, in enemy territory, no less.
That's exactly right. But with the way they controlled the game and just completely took the crowd out of it, that's how to get it done on the road.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much, Kyrie. Nice win tonight. What was your thought process coming into the game?
You know, I was just going out there trying to compete on every play, trying to play as much defense as possible. You know, just sticking to our game plan. We had a game plan going in and we executed.
Got it done at both ends of the floor, Kyrie. Thanks very much. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David. Great job. Thanks so much. And that about wraps it up. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for tuning in. Now time to send you over to the award-winning Ernie Johnson for the postgame show with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith.
The 2K Sports postgame show.
Welcome back, everybody. Ernie Johnson, along with Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith, as we present our Jordan player of the game, Kevin Love. He took control in the first half, gave his teammates a lot of confidence, which ultimately they rode to victory here tonight.
On a night like this, you just have to marvel at the things that Kevin Love can do. Inside, outside, he was everywhere, and there was nothing they could do to stop him. You gotta love the huge contribution he gave them tonight.
After they dropped their two previous games, you can see he was seriously motivated tonight. When times get tough, he's the guy you lean on. He came through with a big win tonight.
And that is a wrap, everybody. Thanks for joining us this evening. For Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith, Kevin Harlan, the entire 2K Sports crew, this is Ernie Johnson. See you again soon.